Hello, this is Connie Belden, and today we're going to talk about the stockholders' equity section of the balance sheet. We've covered the balance sheet in previous chapters. We know that the balance sheet has three parts: assets, liabilities, and stockholders' equity. But up until now, our stockholders' equity section of the balance sheet just had the amount for stock and the amount for retained earnings. So we're going to assume the assets and liability sections have already been done, and we're going to take a look at just the stockholders' equity section, and we're going to expand upon that in this chapter. So first of all, stockholders' equity is comprised of two parts: paid in capital and retained earnings. The retained earnings, of course, is the amount of our profits that's not paid out as dividends. Now, as we talked about previously, a company can sell both preferred stock and common stock. If they don't sell any preferred stock, we would just skip the preferred stock area and go right to common stock. But in this company, let's assume that they do sell preferred stock and the par value is $125 per share. So when you journalize for it, you would have credited preferred stock at its par value. So let's assume the par value was $5 million. You would have also credited the paid in excess account for anything above that $5 million that you sold it for. So let's assume that we sold it for $200,000 above par. So therefore, the paid in excess was $200,000. So those amounts would have just been from our journal entries. We would have posted them to our ledgers to get these amounts here. So the total amount from the sale of our preferred stock is $5.2 million. Then let's assume that we also have sold or issued common stock for $8 par. So again, when we journalized for it, we would have journalized for its par value. Let's assume that's $3 million. And let's assume that we sold it over par for $500,000. So our paid in excess would have been credited for $500,000. So that's where that would come from, for a total sales price of $3.5 million. Now, the other thing that goes into paid in capital is if we had purchased any treasury stock and then we sold it at a gain, we would put just the amount of the gain from that sale in this section. We'll deal with the treasury stock itself in a moment. But let's assume that we had purchased some treasury stock and we resold it for $200,000 more than what we paid for it. So if that's the case, we're at a line that says from sale of treasury stock, not the total sales price, but just the amount above what we paid for it, so a gain of $200,000. Okay. And when I add the preferred stock, common stock, and gain from sale of treasury stock, my paid in capital is $8.9 million. Then we can refer to our ledger balance for retained earnings or to our statement of stockholders' equity to get that our current retained earnings balance is $20 million. Okay, so we would add those last two numbers together. That puts us at $28,900,000. Now, if we currently still have any treasury stock that we have not resold, that comes at the very end as a deduction, because if we own some treasury stock that we haven't resold, that reduces our stockholders' equity. So we always reduce it by the cost of what we paid for the paid for that treasury stock. So let's assume that we still have 888,000 shares of treasury stock that we repurchased at a cost of $792,000. So what we do is we take our total above, subtract $792,000, make sure you subtract that, not add it, because it reduces stockholders' equity. So our total stockholders' equity is $28,108,000. Now that